And now comes the interesting part, because the answer is 2 to the power of n minus 1. The important thing to notice here is the following. So you still have two possibilities of visiting this part here. So there's still two possibilities. And you also have two possibilities for this part here, and all of the other ones in between as well. But here, something interesting happens. If we choose to travel up here, then down here, then it costs us one extra edge to visit clause number 1, as opposed to if we had gone from this vertex here to this one directly. So just one extra edge. Now watch what happens if we go down here. If we were to visit this vertex immediately, then we are over here, which means we haven't yet visited these two vertices here, so we need to go backwards, and then up here, and then back, something like that. So this is not going to be a shortest path, because we're starting to visit cities multiple times. And even if we try to do it another way, so maybe just visit these here first, then we can't go down here again, because then we would again visit cities twice. Also going over here, then up here, then backwards through this. Also, we visit this city here twice. So what you can see is that on a shortest path, if we want to visit this vertex down here, then we must take this route. If we do not have to visit this vertex, then we don't have to take this route, then we can still choose arbitrarily. The number of shortest paths between A and B, if we have to visit that vertex, has been reduced. And that is pretty neat, because that means we can only visit this vertex here on a shortest tour if we are going the right way. And now you can already see the relationship. If we connect this clause here to this part here, which represents a variable in the right way, so that we can only visit the city if the variable is set in the right way, because we said going up here means true, going down here means false, then we can ensure that a shortest path from A to B visits this vertex here, which means that we can also have a satisfying assignment for this clause here. And I'll illustrate this for you in more detail.